I'm going to go through certain, you know, I've categorized this for my own benefit and inshallah your benefit, of the tafsir that I read, how you know, the فَقَدْ اخْتَلَفَ الْمُفَسِّرُونَ فِي هَذَا الْأَمْرِ كَثِيرًا, right? They differed in this a lot when it came to this issue of what this burden is. So the 6 or 7 opinions I did find, I'm going to share them with you bit by bit, so we have a good understanding of what Allah is saying Azza wa Jal when He says He relieved the messenger's burden for him. Let's talk about that. Number one, the burden, and the first one's probably the hardest one to explain. We are living in a time that's very materialistic, and we've become very shallow as human beings. I'm not even talking about religiously. I'm just talking about generally a comment on society, people in general. We've become very materialistic. Our concerns on a day-to-day basis rarely go beyond ourselves. Human beings, I'm not even talking about Muslims, human beings generally, our concerns rarely go beyond ourselves. You're worried about what you're going to eat today, what movie you're going to watch, what video game you're going to play, etc., etc. That's what your head is filled with, okay? Or, you know, what bills you have to pay today. You're concerned, your entire life revolves around yourself. For some people, a little more themselves than themselves, maybe their family, wife and kids. That's it. Now, there are some people that are concerned with a little bit more. What's that little bit more? They're concerned about their neighborhood, right? I don't want this store to open in my neighborhood. I want a stop sign over here. I want this or that. They're socially active a little bit more. So they're concerned with themselves and a little bit beyond themselves. Then there are people that are concerned with it even a little bit more. They don't just think about themselves and their neighborhood. They think about maybe policies, politics. They want to get active in some sort of, you know, join some sort of cause, right? They want to become animal rights or whatever rights, right? And they want to picket for it and this and that. These are people that are now politically active, right? And they're trying to do some sort of humanitarian or other good cause. But even this is all materialistic. Everything so far is concerned for what? Which world? This world. Then there used to be a good number of people in pre-modern society that were not just concerned with what's happening here, but they were concerned, what's going to happen to me after I leave here? Where did I come from? Why am I here? And where am I headed after this is all done? After all, I'm not the first one here. My forefathers have come and gone, and my great-grandparents have come and gone, and just like them, I will come and go. But where will I go? Why did I come and where will I go? They ask deeper questions. They ask, what is this around me? What is justice? How do I find justice in society? How should I live my life? These are deeper questions. The average person you meet, forget asking these deeper questions. They never even think about these deeper questions. They're not that kind of people. Now compare yourself, and by the way, you would say, this is just a, you know, I guess the philosophy professor thinks about these kinds of questions, right? They think about just abstract, foo-foo stuff, you could call it. Doesn't really have to do with the real world kind of thing. They're kind of out there, they're spaced out, they think about these groovy things. But, you should know this. You know how when you don't have food to eat, you feel unrest? You feel like, I need to eat? You know how when you're concerned about your neighborhood and something bad's happening, you get really, like, you lose your sleep over it? When you're concerned about something, it becomes an obsession in your life, you need to fix it. There are some people in humanity, we're not even talking about the messengers yet, we're just some human beings, some general people, the lay population of humanity, they think about these things. And when they think about these things, they're not able to find answers. Why am I here? What's my purpose? Who created me? Do I owe him anything? Right? They think about these things, they try to find their answers at the church. They try to find answers at the temple. They try to find answers at the philosopher. Right? They keep getting answers that they're not satisfied with. And this unrest becomes a burden they live with. It takes over their entire life. Again, most people, not at this level. But there are some people. You know, I'll give you a historical example of such a person. Salman al-Farisi radiallahu anhu. Salman al-Farisi, born of a Zoroastrian, fire-worshipping family, well-off guy, really good life, you know. But he is in a family that worships fire. And he just reflects on, and his father is one of the Templars. He's one of the big chiefs in the temple. And he can't handle this idea. We put the fuel in, why should we ask it for anything? It's asking us for fuel, right? So he thinks about this, and he's not satisfied, and because of that dissatisfaction, he ends up, you know, under the tutelage eventually of a Christian monk and whatnot. Long story short, how many sacrifices is Salman al-Farisi radiallahu anhu willing to go through even before he got to Islam? Even before he got to Islam. Not for the needs of his stomach, not for the needs of his nation, not for the needs of his country, not for anything else, but what quest? You have to call it truth and purpose. That's what he's seeking. And this person, it's amazing, usually we say that the thirsty go to the well, right? But in the case of Salman al-Farisi, it's interesting, the well came to the thirsty. The Messenger ﷺ moved to where? Medina. And Salman al-Farisi radiallahu anhu was a captive in Medina, waiting anxiously that one day he will meet the final Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. These are deep thinkers. Now, this is average human beings. Now let's talk about messengers. Allah made messengers the purest, He selected the purest of people to be His messengers. And the purest of them all, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Do you think He's concerned about, you know, worldly things, even before Islam? Or higher things? He's a deep thinker. He's concerned about higher things. This reality was captured in the previous surah, وَوَجَدَكَ ضَالًّا. He found you seeking. Seeking what? Seeking what? He wasn't satisfied with the society around him. The people that were offering him truth of the unseen, it was dissatisfactory to him. We learn already, he didn't like to play games, he wasn't entertained, he didn't go into any musical types of gatherings, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Even if he was going to pass by there, Allah put him to sleep before he got, you know, and the gathering was done, He would wake him up, right? And then we find Aisha radiallahu anha telling us that as he reached a certain age, you know, there's a certain age of maturity, closer to the age of 40, and this is a sunnah of Allah, around that age Allah chooses His messengers and gives them the message. At this age, what did he start doing even before the revelation came? Where is he going? He's going to a cave. Now, why does someone go to a cave? I mean, today it's a tourist site. You don't go there to reflect and think. You don't go there to check out you go there to check out the view today, right? But why do you originally go to a cave? Why would you leave society? Because whatever's in society seems to put you in even more unrest. It has food for your stomach, but there's something in your chest that's just not sitting well. There's a burden that keeps getting heavier and heavier and heavier upon you, seeking that truth. And Allah Azza wa Jal brought the Messenger to the point. And you know, sometimes Aisha radiallahu anha, for example, narrates that he used to go, but that he told her, that he used to go for days and days and days on end. He would go, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now that's, you know, if you saw a normal person, an average person in society, they just go. They go and they go out camping and they just stay there for weeks and weeks and weeks. Or days and days and days. What would their family start thinking? This person's, we're really worried about him. What's happening to him, right? In other words, this person might snap. الَّذِي أَنْقَضَ ظَهْرَكَ. The Messenger was so desperately seeking the truth, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He came to that desperate point where he even abandoned society. Like, you know, Lucy comments, Shawkani comments, what was he doing in the cave? At-tafakkur, deep thinking. Deep thinking about what? Right? That's the question. And so Allah Azza wa Jal alleviated him of that burden by giving him the answer. He sent him the angel Jibreel, alayhi salam. He sent him, اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق. This is the first interpretation of the burden being alleviated and the chest being expanded for the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.